that our crane cost will be distributed to your steel, concrete, whatever the activity they are doing. If 8 hours that our crane is working in a day, 3 hours it is working for your shutters, and 3 hours for reinforcement, and 2 hours for concreting. Overall cost you remove for particular day, what is the tower crane cost? That cost will be distributed for particular activity. If you are using for the concrete, the tower crane cost has to be distributed. You understand? You understand this concept or not? Activity which we are performing, for that the cost will be adding up. You can't book everything in concrete, because your BOQ items are different. The reinforcement activity is different, shuttering activity is different. You may be engaging 3 different persons for the 3 different activities. Former gang will not do the concrete. Reinforcement gang will not do the concrete. While putting the BOQ, there are so many items are there, concrete, shuttering and reinforcement. So the P&L cost, yes, whatever the required transfer machinery, that has to be booked. You have to identify if it is a high rise, whether I need a tower crane or not. If it is a 3G+3 structure, highest is enough. What is the highest cost? Per month, what is the rent? Whether you are going to, you have in your goodwill, highest available, what is the rent for that? There will be a rent for any machinery. How the rents are calculated, you know? Car loan, you have heard about car loans? How many years they are giving?
Based on?
How many years they are giving? 20 years they are giving?
3 years, 4 years.
3 years, maximum, earlier it was 5 years, now it is 7 years. That is the maximum time. After that, they are not giving loan. Why? They consider that as a zero value. Depreciation. Your car life is 7 years, they think of. If you ask for 10 years car loan, could you? Earlier there was 5 years they kept the period, now 7. Why means they observe after 7 years that will not be useful. That particular, maybe new model may be coming, or this is depreciated, that much only it can run. Engine may be seized or something. If you are taking any Ola or Uber vehicle, mostly in 4 years only it is gone. Life is gone. They can't fund for 20 years that particular. Same thing for construction machinery also. What will be the life, approximate life, and how much work it can be doing. If you take a transit mixer, they will tell 2 lakh kilometers it can run. If you take a tower crane, they will tell this many years it can work. Maybe advanced next stage machine may come, or it becomes obsolete. So, the equipment cost will be distributed over the period of time. You understood? That's like that only the rental cost is derived. If you take a water tanker, same thing. What is the overall cost distributed by number of years? The first year the cost absorption will be more. And keep on going, it will reduce. If you know 1 month cost, then you can distribute where and all it is working. Which area they are working, there you can distribute. If it is working only for A block or B block, there are so many blocks, some one particular area it is working, you can allocate the cost to the particular activity. This is your tools and tackles, you understood? Any doubts on this? Chandan, what about you? P&M, you got it? P&M, if you go for shuttering activity, the tower crane will come. And you are cutting with tools, lot of things which is required to the shuttering work, that will come. If you take in a concrete activity, the vibrator needles will come. Because that is a consumable. Each time frequently using, the needles will get worn out. You need to get the repaired ones. That cost enough will come in your plant and machinery. Reinforcement, your cutting machine. The blades get worn out, after so many times, the blade gets worn out. That blades, that machinery, that related tools and machinery, that cost comes into your P&L. Maybe 1000 tons of steel, you may be requiring 2 bar cutting machines for over the period of 6 months or 3 months. That can you calculate the value, you add that machinery over here. You are seeing the machinery is being used for bar cutting. You understand? You have to list it out for particular activity, what are the machinery is required, tools required, all the associated costs has to come here. Next is profit. What is profit? Overheads and profit. Each activity, how much you will be getting the margins. Everyone is working for some profits only. How much you are making it. If you are allocating one supervisor over there, or one site engineer is working for only for concrete, or he is only a steel person, his cost goes to that particular activity, his supervision. You understand? They might be having everything separate, accumulated indirect cost also, but it has to be allocated in rate analysis in overhead. That is your overhead cost. And the profit. Particular item, how much you are making profit. You may be directly giving the work to subcontract also. Sir, I don't want this headache, sir. This is managed by my subcontract. My actual contractor will come do the work. For that also, you have to ask him, call him for a negotiation and you will take the quotes and all. You will have certain margins over that. Like that also, they will do. Lot of companies, they may not be having that expertise. They don't have excavation machinery. They don't have waterproofing expertise. They hire a third party agency or contractor. They will come. They will give the specifications to them. They will quote for particular activity. Then the overheads has to be added. Because you are calling them and you are making the payments, you are supervising their works also. The fundamental remains same. Any of the item fundamental remains same. LMP, we will say LMP. LMP is labor, material and plant and machinery. That is the basics for anything. Plus your overheads. They will ask first, what is your LMP cost? Give me the breakdown. You just cut the sir 1200 rupees per square meter. How it comes? What is your labor component? What is your material component? What is your plant and machinery component? Like the breakups you have to provide. Then only the cost you can substantiate. That is required for your working. Need list to submit to the clients. You understand? Everything can be done. Broken up like this. Each and every activity in the net analysis you can make it.
Okay, to study the specification, eighth act.
Providing and laying cement concrete using 20 mm and downsized granite jelly of ready mixed concrete RMC. Dump party for RMC works laid in 15 cm thick layers and well compacted vibrating during finishing with necessary cement mortar with all lead and lift etc. Complete for all foundation works including raft up to plinth level. Exclusive of cost of steel and fabrication charges.
What is the item called and what it is? It says the specification.
It says M40 concrete and preferably RMC. It is not site mixed concrete. This rate is applicable only for your RMC. Due to some issues, RMC is strike. But you are operating the same item, it is not allowed. Because this is, they clearly say this is RMC. Site mix, you have to create one more item. That is deviation. You can take the approval parallelly, but this is mentioned for RMC only.
Okay, if you are quoting for RMC, what do you do? How will you quote? So you have to get a quote from the RMC vendor, right? So then if you want to quote for RMC vendor, what will you specify? How you send the quotation to the RMC vendor? What will you ask? I want a quotation for M40 grade concrete. How will you specify? What are the inputs you have to give to the contractor to get the quotation for the same item?
Volume of concrete. How much volume of concrete we need?
Volume of concrete.
What is volume of concrete? Grade of concrete. Okay. Then? Grade of concrete, will you be able to quote? for M40 concrete, how he will be able to quote? Just imagine you are a contractor. I am asking you for M40 concrete. You give me a quotation. Will you be able to give? What you'll ask me? Next.
What are the ingredients?
Ingredients are fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, cement. Right.
M40 is there 28 days strength?
That will say, will give you the...
See, they will mainly ask your lead, where is your project site. Based on that, the price will change. If your RMC is nearby and the project site also is nearby, the cost will be compared to less than if it is far away. They will ask first question, where is your site? How much concrete required? What is the grade? And when you require?
And also, you are asking for the design. Because there you will have the plasticizer, what is the plasticizer to be used, what is the volume to be used, how much cement is required, that is the measure for M40 grade of concrete. What is the cement content required? As per IS, what, you have any idea? What is the cement, minimum cement content required for M40? For M20? That is the mix.
320.
M20, 320 kg. So 320 to 340. So M25, 340 to 360. M30, it is in that range. So you may go with 400 kg also. M40. 400 to 420. So in that range. So you have to give the cement content. What is the minimum cement content required to prepare this mix? Right? So then after specifying all these things only, the contractor also will give you a quotation. Otherwise, you will not get any data. He will give you data, a standard data, but it depends on the project. It's project specified. So you will have different things, what is not given by the supplier. So that time you will have a problem. It may end up with loss also. So you have to clearly specify the specification to your vendor also. So then you have to say what is the cement required. Based on that only you can give a quotation. Then only you can give the code, right? RMC M40. What is the price? Just tell me general. Anybody know the price for RMC?
$7,000
per MQ. What is the grade?
M40.
M40, yeah. 7,000. Is it with the pure cement or fly ash? Cementitious. Right? M sand or river sand?
M sand.
M sand.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is cementitious, right? What is cementitious? What is meant by cementitious?
Instead of cement, they are adding fly ash.
They will add fly ash. Instead of pure cement, they add fly ash. Then you call it as cementitious. So you have you will be adding 20-40% cementation, fly ash. You have eligibility. So then you call it as cementitious, or then specifically pure cement only. You do not add any fly ash. Then you say it's a pure cement. Or river sand. Combination 50%, 50%. So it is project specific. Then concrete, you got labor charges for. How you are going to do the concrete? Whether you are going to do the concrete using pump or by manual dumping. You will dump it here, by manual you will shift. So that we do not know. Okay? I am assuming that pumping by 50%. So 50% of the RMC will be by pumping. 50% of the RMC will be done by dumping, right? So I need to take the metal by leading. So 7250 is your cost per m cube. Cost per m cube. You add your overheads and profits, 15%. Rate per entry is your sales price. It's the same thing if I work with site mix, what will be my cost? Huh? We'll see that also. Whether it is less or more. Finished? What is the price we have given earlier for fine aggregate? 1750. 1765. What's aggregate? 1050. Huh?
1059.
This platinum machinery, we are putting 75 in general, it is not very vague, it has got some analysis. What we do? So what are the platinum machinery required for concrete that we will list out? Then how much time it is required? So based on the schedule, the concrete duration will take. So how many metal, how much metals is required? For example, platinum machinery, we use ash, wire, vibrator, mixer machine. So first we will calculate the duration, how long it is required, higher charges. The total value will take. So the total cost for concrete will be plant and machinery cost will be this much. How you incorporate here? So the total value divided by the total concrete quantity is nothing but the plant and machinery for concrete will be that much. For example, if you are using ice, you will be using ice for concrete work, brick work, and for plastic, mortar shifting, crane. Suppose you are using crane for shifting the shattering metal, for shifting the reinforcement, for shifting the bricks, shifting the concrete, everything will be there. How you split that? What is the coefficient to be given for each and every item? So when we have the our rate sales price, what is the component in the overall cost price, overall our project value? What is the component involved for concrete? We'll work out the coefficient. That value will be multiplied to the higher charges. So you give some value. So that much of percentage is loaded for each and every item. Simple, okay? That is how we take it. This water also 180 liter. How we got it? It is based on water cement ratio. So, water cement ratio I have taken 0.45. So, based on that. So, if it is 8 weight bags means 8 into 50, 400 kgs. 400 kg into 0.5 will be 200 liters. I have taken 0.45. So, 180 liters.